So I bring the question to you, Brian, knowing that you're a fan of Final Fantasy XI. In a perfect world where you get everything you want, what would this something big for the game be? Then knowing we won't get everything we want, more than likely, what is a compromise that would make you happy? And finally, what do you realistically expect for them to do for the 20th anniversary? I've been just kind of reading the reading the Yoshi P and the Square Enix blogs and coming up with my insane theories, getting those readings of, you know, spider senses tingling. So I haven't shared my thoughts on what I've been calling in my mind the convergence. For the past 3 years, I've been operating on this theory that something big is coming to Final Fantasy XIV, and despite having a record of predicting what's happening with the world of Final Fantasy XIV, I want to state clearly that this video is for entertainment purposes only, and I don't want to get anyone's hopes up with my sane theories. So it's with that I want to take some time and share with you guys my hopes and dreams for after Endwalker. This is not going to have any spoilers for the story or anything like that. This is more what I see to be true, what we know, what's been stated both from the Final Fantasy XI team and the Final Fantasy XIV team. Like I said, this is for entertainment purposes. This is just for general discussion. Feel free to sound off on anything I share with you guys here in this video. I'd love to hear your thoughts, and let's have some fun with this topic, because right now anything is possible. And at the end of the day, if any of this ends up being true, it's just going to be something fun that we can both be excited about and share together. But here's what we know to be true. Here's what the developers have said. Here's what we know from multiple different sources. And so let's just start at the beginning. During the original development, when they were planning Final Fantasy XIV, there was a lot of talk about having the Mog room in Final Fantasy XI act as a gateway between Final Fantasy XI and Final Fantasy XIV. This was essentially to try to solve the migration problem that we see with MMORPGs. Moving one community from one game to the next is impossible. In fact, Yoshi P even stated so on several of his long day live letters as a part of 14-hour streams. Just the difficulty or the insane pain it would be to sit here and try to move players from Final Fantasy XIV into a new Square Enix Final Fantasy MMORPG. Now, Final Fantasy XI and Final Fantasy XIV are also now still under the leadership of Yoshi P. So he's in charge of both development teams under Business Division 3. Over 3 years ago, Final Fantasy XI's dev team actually announced that they were working on something big for Final Fantasy XI's 20th anniversary, thus kind of the original quote at the beginning of this video. We're going to explore that here as well. They also said that since they've been talking about how important Final Fantasy XI is to the gaming world as we know it over on the We Are Vanadil website, which actually I've been covering several of the interviews here on Ginger Prime. You can check the Final Fantasy playlist if you're interested in that. Also, Final Fantasy XI R, which was essentially a mobile remake, which had everybody kind of nervous, especially Final Fantasy XI fans, but there's a lot of potential in the mobile market, was actually canceled. This was done by Nexion with relation and in cooperation with Square Enix, but that has been canceled, and that was actually being built in Unreal. So we'll come back to that thought here in just a little bit. Also, in Final Fantasy XIV's case, Yoshi P has stated at some point the number 14 won't make any sense. It's just not going to make any sense to be playing Final Fantasy XIV at some point when Final Fantasy 30 is out or something like that. Also, at Endwalker is the end of the Zodiark Hydaelyn saga. That's not a spoiler. We know that for a fact. 6.0, the expansion, finishes off the story, where in previous expansions, the 0.3 patch of the content that follows the expansion finishes off that story of that expansion. 6.0 is the conclusion of the Hydaelyn Zodiark story, but that does not end the game. He's been very clear about that. And also, Yoshi P is also very excited to share with us what his plans are after Endwalker and for the next 10 years with this game itself. Yoshi P is also planning on sharing those plans with us in 2022, which aligns with Final Fantasy XI's 20th anniversary and Final Fantasy XIV's 12th anniversary. A lot of numbers for you guys here now, right now. So, what is the convergence in my mind? First and foremost, it's actually two things. It's learning about the possible future for both Final Fantasy XI and Final Fantasy XIV. That's kind of the baseline thought here. It's also hoping that these two games become one game, Final Fantasy Online. So how could this even work? Now, remember the core question that kicked off this video? Obviously, like, yeah, in a world where I get everything I want, in a world, something that I can settle for, and in a world, what do I think they're going to do for the 20th anniversary? That's what this is all going to be breaking down here for you now. Well, for the longest time, and for perhaps the most common sense approach, is to actually just to combine the game's subscription into one. They did this for a short period of time, actually, when Final Fantasy XIV launched, but they never continued it or even talked about it again. In fact, if you see anybody with the Hermes shoes in the game, it's a special pair of shoes that actually has a perk to it, unlike anything else in any of the other pieces of gear in the game. That's how you got that back in the day. You had a combined subscription, and it only lasted for a few months. Anyway, a little fun fact of history for Final Fantasy XIV for you guys out there in the audience. But even if they don't dramatically update, obviously, Final Fantasy XI, how awesome would it be just to bring these games into the Final Fantasy XIV launcher and under one shared account? That is my wish. Really kind of bridging also the gap of the friends list, maybe even possibly link shells. I think communication would be key. This is what I hope, like outside of like engines and graphics and things like that, one combined sub, one account, and then essentially having that ability to communicate between the two games, whether you're playing one or the other, having that unique friends list, having that set up between the two. Ultimately, whether I'm playing 11 or 14, I'm not, you know, disconnected. In fact, I could be trying to maybe farm up an NM in Final Fantasy 11, and I can message those in my link shell or my free company and say, hey, you know, guys, it's gonna go ahead and pop. Why don't you, oh, y'all aren't doing anything? You're just kind of hanging out? Hop over here, let's do some 11, and then we can pop back there. Like, having and bridging that gap, I think, would be one of the steps of moving things closer into Unity. The real wish, obviously, is to see Vanadil reimagined. So in a world where I get everything I want, I would love to see Vanadil reimagined with Final Fantasy XIV's new world. And I know that I've been loving and playing and talking about new world. I mean the new world actually in Final Fantasy XIV, which is to the west of the continents that we know of. So we haven't ever seen it. We've only seen a little taste of it with the Blue Mage storyline in the world. So that's kind of a little hint that, you know, there's something over there. And I think how amazing and mind-blowing and radical would it be that all of a sudden, if we got to go see Bastok, Winder, Sandy, completely reimagined. Now, as to what timeline that would be, whether that's in the future or that's in the past, honestly, it's all up for question and excitement and discussion at this point. But how cool would that be? Talking, and this is where it gets a little bit tricky. I know when I sit here and talk about Final Fantasy XI, there's the purist out there, and then there's the, I guess I would consider myself more of kind of a bridging the gap between the two styles of game. Final Fantasy XI, you know, has this hardcore, you really fight for everything kind of mindset, and I wouldn't want that to go away, but I think there's some quality of life improvements that would make it easier for people to kind of step into that world without having it be so harsh right at the start. I have no issue with grinding for levels. Honestly, that's why I play MMORPGs. I find a lot of joy and passion and relaxation, oddly enough, from that. But I know that when we talk about modernizing Final Fantasy XI, it is a tricky topic depending on who you're talking to. So sound off with what you would be willing to see changed about 11. But again, graphic-wise, imagine the Final Fantasy XI Vanadil world, like really reimagined. Really just visually lush and beautiful. Final Fantasy XIV is a very beautiful game, and we cannot deny that fact. There's also very many interesting choices and ideas that pop in my head. Like, what if there was actually a gateway between the games? You know, like I said with Final Fantasy XI Online, it's not 17. It's not any other numbered Final Fantasy. But in joining, or perhaps a rejoining, for those of you who will, these two amazing games and their communities could be a real strength for Square Enix over the long run. Final Fantasy XIV, also Yoshi-P stating, Square Enix will spare no expense. Final Fantasy XIV is their most profitable game to date. Final Fantasy XI is the record that they broke. Like, these, they should clearly see the value of these online communities, and do, in my opinion. I would just like to see Final Fantasy XI have some kind of direction, some kind of future, because it feels like it's just been in limbo. But they've been updating it, and they said that they've been working on it for over 3 years. We'll have to see what happens, what that actually means, obviously here in 2022. Now, having obviously said all this, I know Final Fantasy XI fans obviously want Final Fantasy XI preserved. like it is now, and obviously just with just updated graphics. So maybe there's a compromise there. Maybe they could bring up Final Fantasy XI with Final Fantasy XIV's graphics engine and still keep the core of what made it great. But also I would ask to maybe be a little bit flexible for it. You know, being able to explore that world could be really interesting and exciting to see. The other thing about all of it, though, when we talk about both 11 and 14, they're stylized, not just visually, but like, and not just set up on time, two different ways. 11 is a sandbox MMORPG. Final Fantasy 14 is a theme park MMORPG. And Yoshi P has commented how that he sees the demand for that hardcore MMORPG. And he's even stated multiple times, that's his kind of game. That's what he would love to make. That's what he loves to play. But the business side of it, the cost of keeping that up, the cost of doing those kind of things, it can't be business justified in 2022. But all of a sudden, you have that hardcore MMORPG and that theme park MMORPG, and you combine them together, maybe then we would actually see development and more updates happening on the hardcore side of things, because it doesn't have to justify its whole cost. You can have a balance. And again, connecting those two communities at its core, I think would be critical. So obviously the biggest, you know, like I said, you know, getting everything I want a modern Final Fantasy XI. Like when I play New World, the visual fidelity of that game, I'd love to see what Square Enix could do and invest in. And at the same time, I know that it's not going to be easy moving players from one community to the next. So why try? Bring them together. Convergence, if you will. Now, that's obviously just my theory, just my thoughts. I'd be happy, again, at the very minimum, a combined subscription. At a middle ground, it would be kind of neat to see Vanadil and all that within the world of Final Fantasy XIV, even if it wasn't converging and actually pulling in 11. I'd still love to see what that would look like, and then how that would play with the world and the story. Anything at all is really exciting at this point, because Final Fantasy XIV is clearly doing things right. The team has a plan, and Yoshi P plans to share it with us here after Endwalker. We also will learn about the future of Final Fantasy XI after Endwalker. 2022 really is starting to set itself up as this pivotal moment. So even if none of this comes to pass, I'm very excited to see what's coming out of Division 3, here in 2022. Because, like, we haven't even talked about 16. And that's a thing. Anyway, guys, that's it for this video. Hopefully you enjoyed. Hopefully you got something fun out of it and got some just joy in your day. Something to be excited about for the future of both Final Fantasy 11 and 14. Sound off it below, like I said, with your thoughts, your theories. And yeah, let's have that conversation. And that's going to wrap it up, guys. If you feel like I earned it, hit that like button. If you feel like I earned it, hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. And I'll let me welcome you over here to this channel, where I like talking about MMORPGs and video games and so much more. For Ginger Prime, my name is Brian. And I didn't do this at the start, so I'll do it right now. For returning subscribers, you are legendary. And honestly, today, your eyes are on fire. Not literally, like, but they are just looking good. Your eyes could pierce the heart of the darkest dragon. Anyway, guys, that's going to be it for me. Thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. You're awesome. And hopefully I'll see you in my next video. But until then, take care.
I just want to say I'm really glad y'all feeling better, and I love the videos. Well, I love you too, Michelle. Shoot for the moon, and so even if you fail, you'll reach the stars. Go for the 100K subscribers.